Alex from ACTEGA, and I would like to show you today how to avoid microfoam in your coatings. Microfoam looks like this, and it is a result of air distribution in the coating. If foam occurs in the coating container, processing problems may be the consequence. This is followed by transfer disturbances or air inclusions in the dried coating layer. The coated printed product loses gloss and scuff resistance. If foam appears in the chamber doctor blade or roller system, a partial drying of the coating is possible. So let's take a quick look at the solution of this problem. With the following 5 steps, you can act successfully against microfoam. If coating suction and return flow are positioned incorrectly, air can be taken into the coating. Foaming is the result. To avoid this, you have to install the coating suction and return flow deeply below the coating surface on the wall of the container. If your coating pump is running too fast, foam may easily be formed. Choose the speed of your coating pump just as high as it is necessary for the coating unit to be filled and emptied properly. Defoamers eliminate and prevent foaming. If you add defoamer to your coating, pay attention to the correct dose. Otherwise, it may come to an incompatibility between defoamer and coating. The consequence? Altered coating characteristics and surface disturbances in the dried coating layer. Fast running membrane or rotary pumps can positively influence the occurrence of foam. Prefer to use a peristaltic pump because it operates in a gentler way. Many coatings contain raw materials with a foam building structure. Often these raw materials are necessary for the functionality of the coating. A replacement is hardly possible. Therefore, please contact our technical service. That's it! I hope this short video helped you to fix your issues at the printing press. If you have any further questions, please don't hesitate to contact us. See you soon in our next video. Bye!